Dear students, consider the clinical features: cerebellar ataxia, peripheral neuropathy. Also consider your ichthyosis in case of skin, retinitis pigmentosa in your eye. Now, the combination of these clinical features is referred to as refsum disease. You have two types of refsum disease: adult refsum disease ARD and infantile refsum disease IRD. ARD is of two types, ARD1 and 2. ARD1 has PAH gene mutation, which is phytanic acid hydroxylase deficiency. And in case of ARD2, you will be having PEX mutation. In case of IRD, we have PEX7 specific mutation. Now, the infantile refsum disease is a very horrible, rapidly progressing kind of disease compared to that of adult refsum disease. But the IRD is a part of a bigger concept called as peroxisomal biogenesis disorder, which contains the Zellweger spectrum. In that, the Zellweger spectrum has the most severe version referred to as Zellweger syndrome, and we have the moderate version referred to as neonatal adrenal leukodystrophy, and the mildest version referred to as this infantile refsum disorder. So remember, adult refsum disorder and infantile refsum disorder are different, and in case of infantile refsum disorder, the clinical course is rapidly progressive and horribly ending up. Here, in case of infantile refsum disease, accumulation of very long chain fatty acids and phytanic acid happens, but in case of adult refsum disease, only phytanic acid will be accumulating, because of which very high levels of phytanic acid can be noticed. I hope this will help. All the best.